Hello everyone, welcome to Professor DK, and in this video tutorial I'm going to show you how you can add two numbers using Android Studio. So let's quickly start a new Android Studio project. So under application name I'm just gonna say adding two numbers demo, and let's leave other things as default and click on next. Make sure the phone and tablet option is checked and click on next. Let's choose the empty activity and proceed. So let this be main activity and click on finish. Once your Gradle build has finished, then you can see that, you know, I have my activity main.xml and main activity.java opened here. If you do not have this, do not worry. Make sure at the top left corner, make sure you are in the Android folder, and then under apps you should find the Java package, and under that you should have your main activity. Just click on it and you will get the main activity.java, and for the layout file you can click on resources, and under layout you should have your activity main.xml. Now let's create the physical layout for our app. So under activity main.xml, under the text section, you have your constraint layout. So we don't need this. And under design tab, we are going to add our two edit text, which will enable us to add our numbers. So here we have our blueprint as well as the main design. So what I'm going to do is, firstly, I'm going to remove this hello world. So just click on it and press delete. So let's go ahead and start creating our layout. So firstly, we need the edit text, which will enable us to input the number. So place it here, and before we can proceed to adding the other widgets, we need to constrain this in the blueprint. So since it is the constraint layout, we need to constrain it to the top and the bottom and also to the sides. So now that we have constrained this, we can move it. So I placed it somewhere around the top. And after this, make sure you change the ID of the edit text. So how do you do that? So at the rightmost corner, you should see the ID under properties. So change this ID to etnum1. So et basically stands for edit text, and I'm calling this num1. So etnum1 without any spaces. So make sure you create that ID and then click on enter. All right. So we have created our first widget. Now let's go ahead and add the second number, and we're gonna follow the same procedure that we did earlier. So we need to constrain it to the top. So we need to constrain it with the previous edit text, and we'll constrain this to the bottom and the sides as well. So now that we have constrained it on all the four sides, we can move it around. So it is placed exactly below our first edit text. Now that we have placed it, again we are gonna follow the same procedure. We need to rename this ID. Let's call this etnum2 without any spaces and click on enter. So now that we have added our two edit texts, we can go ahead and add the button which will let us add the two numbers upon entering. So we have our button as well. So we need to constrain this in the same way that we did earlier. So constrain it to the previous edit text, constrain it to the bottom and to the sides as well. So now that we have constrained it on all four sides, we can move it around. Let's rename the ID as btn add. Btn basically is short for button and add. So click on enter, and now we can go ahead and add our text view, which is for displaying the answer. So click on text view and drag it to our layout, and we need to follow the same procedure. We need to constrain it to the previous widget, which was the button, and to the bottom and to the sides as well. So this is as simple as it can get, and move it around exactly below the button. And as I have done previously, change the ID to TV answer. Alright, so I have created our layout with all our four widgets. Also make note of the edit text that you have added. We have added the numbers edit text. So what this means is, this will only let you add the positive numbers as input. If you want even integers, suppose negative numbers, you can go ahead and add the number signed one. So to make it quite simple, I have taken the numbers as it is, the unsigned one. So before we go ahead to writing the Java code, let's call this button as add. So click on the button, and under properties, again on the right, you should see the text under text view, and you can change this to add. So right, type add and then click on enter. So you should see it change here. So now that we have done that, also we'll change the text view. So change the text of text view to answer. Alright, and click on enter. So as you can see, we have the answer, but since it's not visible, let's make this a little larger. So for that, you can go ahead to the text section and find text view. So under text view, what you need to do is you need to add a piece of code. So just type text size, and you should have Android Studio autocomplete it for you. Please note the way in which I'm typing. I'm not actually typing Android colon text view. I'm just typing text view and then clicking on the autocomplete. So I'm just gonna give it the value of 32 scale independent pixels SP. So if I see design now, it should be somewhat larger. So we have created our layout, and we have added IDs to each one of them. So now that we have completed our layout design, we can go ahead and write the Java code to add all these, to add the two numbers. So firstly, in mainActivity.java, you need to create variables for each of these widgets. So to create variables, we call it private because we do not want these variables to be accessed in other Java files. So private, and we have to edit text. So edit text, and call this as num1. Alright, and since we have another edit text, we are gonna call this num2, and we have a button as well. So private button add, and we have private text view answer. Let's call this result. Alright, so if you see here, since we do not have the package of button, it's highlighted in red. So how do you import the package? So go to the end of the line, and it says that you have to click on Alt and Enter. So click Alt and Enter simultaneously, and you should have the package imported. So if you see here under import section, you have the button. So as you can see, we do not have the text view yet. So what I'm gonna do is go to the end of the line, and you should have the text view highlighted, and you should get an underline below it, and then you can click on Alt Enter. So if you saw here, the text view got added by itself. So that's the beauty of Android Studio. It, you know, makes it so easy to code. Now that we have created our variables, let's assign it to the IDs in the XML layout. So how do you do that? So num1 is our first variable. We need to typecast it with the widget that we have specified earlier, which was edit text. So edit text, and then we need to do a find view by ID. So find view by ID is a function by Android Studio, which lets you to, you know, reference it with the XML layout. So find view by ID, and inside this you need to type r.id, which is, r is the r file which has all the IDs of your XML layout, and r.id. If you remember, we had used et num1 as the ID of our first edit text. Now similarly, we need to reference our second variable as well. So typecast it with the widget that we have specified earlier, and do a find view by ID, and inside this r.id. et num2. Alright, so next is add, which is a button. So we need to typecast it with button, and then again find view by ID r.id. If you remember, it was btn add. Next we have our result, which is the text view to display our answer. So text view, and again find view by ID r.id. tv answer. So we have referenced all our variables with the corresponding ID in the XML layout. So now that we have referenced all our variables with the respective IDs in the XML layout, we can go ahead and add the two numbers. So when do the two numbers get added? Only when the add button is clicked, right? So for that, what we need to do is we need to set an onClick listener on the add button. So add.set onClick listener. Make sure you type exactly the way I'm typing. If you noticed, I'm just typing the first two letters and then you're getting the autocomplete option. So new, and you can see that onClick listener has been autocompleted for me. So when I click on this, it generates the code by itself. Now, if you just type new view.onClick, it's not gonna work. You need to type exactly the way I'm typing. So inside this, what we need to do is, firstly, we need to retrieve the numbers which were typed inside the edit text. So for that, let's create our integers here. So int number one, no spaces, and num1.getText.toString. Now, since our number is an integer data type, we need to convert this string to integer. So how do you do that? So we'll use our integer.parseInt function, which is used exactly in this case. So we have converted our string to an integer. I'm gonna do the same for our second number as well. So just copy this and paste it here, and we need to change this number one to number two and the number one edit text to number two edit text. So we have got our two numbers and we have placed it in our two variables. So let's go ahead and create a sum variable, and we are gonna give this the value of number one added with number two. Okay, so now that we have added our two numbers and the result is now stored in the sum variable. Now what we need to do is we have to set this sum to our result, which is the text view. So result dot set text, and inside this we need to pass the result. So firstly, let's type answer, you know, so that it is seen properly. So answer colon and some space, and I'm gonna add it with our result variable. So since the sum what we have obtained is an integer, we need to convert it to a string. So for that, we'll do string dot value of, and inside this we're gonna pass sum. Alright, quickly click on the green play button on top, and you should see your device listed here. Suppose your device isn't detected, or you know, you do not know how to run the app on your phone, make sure you watch the video which I've done previously on how you can run the app on your phone. I'll leave the link in the description below. So click on OK and you should have the app running on your phone perfectly. So in the app, when you click on the first edit text, you can see that it only allows you to input numbers because you have taken the numbers edit text. So you can go ahead and add some numbers here, and for the second I'm gonna add 45. So click on add, and then you know, you should see our answer displayed here. So this is a simple way in which you can you know, make an app to add two numbers. So similarly, you can change this to subtract, and you can also do a couple of changes with regard to layout. Another interesting fact is that suppose I do not enter anything in the first column and enter another number here and click on add, the app is gonna crash because we have not added any error handling function here. So everyone, make sure you give it a try on how you can solve this error. So I'll just give you a clue. So what you need to do is you need to, you know, check if the length of the first edit text is zero or not for both of these edit texts. So make sure you check the length before you let them click on the add button. So make sure you do this homework so that it will help you learn much quicker and better. So I believe in applying and learning. So make sure you try to solve that error. So if you like this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up. Also, don't forget to subscribe so that you don't miss out on any of my future videos. The continuation of this video is the calculator app. So this will get much more advanced, and you can have options for add, subtract, multiply and divide as well. So do check out that video. I'll leave the link in the description below. Thank you guys for watching. Happy learning.